I once had an anatomy professor who swore that the best way to remember that oxytocin was the hormone involved in parent-child bonding was to imagine your octopus mother reaching out and grabbing your toe because she loves you. What? I'm sorry, Dr. McGregor. Not only is that still not quite the exact sound pattern of the word oxytocin, but now I have to remember three things instead of just remembering that one concept. There's gotta be a better way to use mnemonics without wasting my time. I'm Andrew with Brainscape, an adaptive flashcards platform built on decades of proven cognitive science research into how we study more effectively. And if there's one tactic that actually helps you learn faster and remember for longer, it's not mnemonics, it's spaced repetition. The act of repeating harder concepts more frequently until you know them well enough to space the repetitions longer and longer apart. For most concepts, this is all you need for efficient learning. As the ancient Romans said, repetition is the mother of all learning. And I trust that from people who used to memorize 500-page epic poems and folk stories for generations before they were written down. Spaced repetition is critical for any type of learning, whether you're talking about guitar drills or multiplication tables, or yes, studying flashcards for complex concepts or vocabulary words. Just repeating the concept in the right expanding intervals of time, and especially varying up the way you practice it, is more than enough to help you remember something permanently without having to develop additional imagery or stories about everything and doubling the amount that you're gonna have to now remember. You should be able to accomplish all this automated spaced repetition with a flashcard app like Brainscape, but there are two cases where a mnemonic can still be useful, especially if they are also combined with adaptive flashcards. Number one is as a last resort. Like a really friggin' hard word or name that you'll just never remember unless you associate it with something silly. Or number two, for words in a series, like remembering the order of the planets, let's say. Right? My very educated mother just served us nine.
Hello.
Oh man, I think I'm gonna need a new mnemonic for that one. Yet another example of mnemonics making things more complicated and not being timeless. I mean, seriously, even the word mnemonics starts with a freaking M. So how straightforward could they be? Okay, I might be setting myself up here for a little bit of hate in the comments from all the fervent followers of the religion of mnemonics. So I should say again, mnemonics can be an occasional good tactic to remember things, just as long as you don't create too many mnemonics, or else each one is no longer going to be so salient in your brain. Save them for the emergencies where you just really can't remember something. If you like this advice, or if you hate it and you want to come argue with us, then please subscribe to this channel, check out all of our other research over at the Brainscape Academy, and keep up that drive to learn more efficiently so that you can rise to any challenge.